Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll learn how to make a Google Ad product feed for WooCommerce. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. Now let's go ahead and create a feed for Google AdWords. Click on New Feed. Once you have done that, let's keep the country as United States. The template we need to choose is Google Ads. Let's give it a name, Google Ads 1. And for the feed type, we need to choose CSV. Let's scroll down. Now here you'll see all the different attributes that's relevant for your AdWords. To understand what these attributes mean and what the specifications are, let's look at the Google documentation. Click on Read Article. This will redirect you straight to the Google Ads help page. And if you scroll down and you expand on custom, you will see all the different attributes and their specifications. So now let's have a read and see what they actually represent. We can see that for a Google AdWords feed, you can have two IDs. You have ID and you have ID2. The ID is a unique sequence of letters and digits, and it has to be unique. And the ID2 is also the same, but it also represents a little bit more about the product. So let's go back to our page and set this up. For our ID, the product ID is a unique value, so we can definitely use that. And for ID2, let's use the SKU ID, as this is also a unique value for our products. Now the item title is great, final URL is a product URL. Everything else looks great. Price, sale price. There's another attribute that we can add for prices, which is the formatted price. Let's go ahead and take a look at that attribute. The formatted price is used in conjunction with the price. So let's go ahead and set this up. For our formatted price, we're just going to add new attribute. Formatted price. For the output, we're going to use regular price and we're going to add a dollar sign right before it as the prefix. Other thing that you can add to your feed are contextual keywords. These are basically keywords that represents the item even more. So let's say, for example, I am selling a graphic t-shirt. Examples of keywords would be like apparel, graphic, and let's say the t-shirt is the color green. These are basically contextual keywords that represents the item even further. One thing we need to make sure is that these keywords need to be separated by colons. Let's have a quick read in our documentation. As you can see, contextual keywords are text and they need to be separated by semicolons if there are multiple keywords. Let's space them out. Great. The next attribute that we have is the item address. Now there is a few different ways you can add the item address to your feed. Let's have a quick look at the documentation. As you can see, for the item address, you can either use the city, state code, country, you can use the full address with the zip code, or you can use the latitude and longitude in the DDD format. These are examples of what it will look like. For our feed, let's say we're going to use the city, state code, and the country. So I'm just going to copy this example and I'll paste it in our feed. There we go. Let's update and generate this feed now. Now that our feed has been successfully generated, let's go ahead and download it. Now it's time to go to our Google Ad Center and upload this feed. Now we're in Google Ad Center. Let's go ahead and click on Tools and Setting. Under Tools and Setting, under Setup, click on Business Data. Once you've done that, here you'll be allowed to create new data feeds. Click on the plus icon to create a new data feed. Go to Dynamic Ad Feed, and since we use the custom attributes to create our feed, you'll be choosing this, Custom, under Dynamic Ad Feed. Let's go ahead and click that. Let's give it a name. Let's keep it consistent with our feed. Here, I'll choose the feed file that I've downloaded earlier. Let's go to Desktop, Google Ads, Upload. There we go. Let's go ahead and apply this. It's uploading it right now. All right, there we go. The feed has successfully been uploaded, as you can see here. You can click here to view the details. Voila, as you can see, we have successfully uploaded all of our products into the Google Ad feed. If there are any error messages, you see the error messages here, and under this column, you'd be able to see exactly where the error is and later on fix that issue. There you go, guys. Now you know how you can create a Google Ad product feed for WooCommerce. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.